is Trey Jim. I am an actualized post-narrative deathless wanderer and one of the tour guides of VR Travelers. We create immersive story-based tours with original writing, beautiful worlds, voice acting, and wholesome team effort. Welcome to the Rendezvous, our point of contact to narrative domains. Tonight, we will be telling the story of the agent, and we will be on the path to the neutral ending. You are welcome to stream and record tonight's event. My friends, we have only two roles. First, as with any real tour in the real world, politely stay with me. And second, each time we walk from place to place, kindly stop talking for narration to continue each time we come to the next point. However, you are encouraged to talk amongst yourselves while we walk. Now, my friends, I am going to drop an Invite Plus portal to the instance for the agent. Since this is Invite Plus, if for any reason you need to get back into the world, you will need to send someone else in the world an invite request, which means you need to make sure you have friends going in with you. If you wish, you are welcome to add myself or my fellow tour guides Rindizo and Nick as friends. We will accept your friend requests. Now, my friends, please do not enter the portal until I give the all clear. Wait for me on the other side. Stepping off a late night train with shards of glass in my hair, a graze from a bullet on my left arm, and a limp from the fall. I bet you're wondering how I ended up like this. Well, let's just say that I learned some things, found some truths they didn't want me to find, and they decided to try and silence me. Tried to silence the wrong man. I got away from their first attempt with a few scrapes and bruises, but now got some news reports coming in. Breaking news, cyber terrorist attacks. Apparently hasn't been identified yet. Well, that's just typical. Justifies lethal force by the lead heads. Well, it's a good thing I left my PDA behind. Good luck tracking me now. In case it ain't obvious, I'm an agent, a hitman for the director of District 54A of the Gray City, under an organization that brands itself as the PSO. My job is to target criminals who are either too rich or too powerful to take down using the law. Well, that was my job. And now? Well, now, I'd like to have a little talk with this director of PSO. Let me ask you something. Expect it to fade into nothing like all dreams do. But as the hours tick by, you realize you weren't dreaming. They were memories. They feel like memories. Memories of things you've never done. Memories of seeing the sun. Memories of having a woman safe in your arms. Memories of a child calling you dad. They feel so real, so convincing. And you will. Know what they did to me. My brain isn't all mine. My brain is a machine. Cyborg. Either they put this brain in me, or I had it the whole time, and they fucked it. Either way, they stole who I was, who I am, away from me. Stole my love. Stole my family. Stole the people I love. And I ain't letting nobody get away with that. Director, we are gonna have a real good talk. And he's gonna talk, or he's gonna find out just what kind of machine he's created. Alright, let's get to work. Gotta lay low, gotta be careful who I talk to. And I gotta avoid identifying myself. Luckily, things are a bit crazy around here. Looks like the small quake that happened during the train ride has shaken things up a little. There's workers about everywhere, so it shouldn't be too hard to blend into the crowds here. But they're gonna be looking for me, so I gotta keep moving. Well, I've got my ticket. Ticket scanners are this way. That tremor really did a number on this place. Well, you know what they say. The world is dying, and we killed it. You know what I say? There's only one thing I give a damn about, and it ain't the world. I can see an old payphone up the steps to the arcade. But I see some cameras too. I gotta keep my head low. At least I hope the sound of the arcade should drown out my voice. Away, hypnotized by the lights, sounds, colors. It's like them machines have stolen a piece of their souls. I guess I know how that feels. All right, now, who to call? Think. I've got it. I've got a tech friend who worked for PSO some years back. He's broken away now, and he's the kind of guy obsessed with security. Lives alone, stays online, covers his tracks real mysterious. But I need someone with that precious inside knowledge. And an old-fashioned payphone is the perfect opportunity. Pick up the damn phone. Hey.
Hello? Who's this?
It's me. Listen, I need to know what's going on. What code have they got on me?
I thought you might contact me.
I already checked.
Yeah.
You've got a code 6 on you, mate. Damn. Well, that ain't good.
Yeah. Where are you right now? What are you doing?
Oh, I'm at the station. You know, the one below PSO HQ.
What?
Mate, you're crazy.
What are you doing there?
I'm gonna have a friendly little chat with the director.
I see. I get it. Right, listen. I know a way to get you past security. But you're gonna have to get your hands dirty. It'll be just like the old days.
Fine by me. What's your idea?
Well, you know, one of my favorite hobbies is spying on security systems. I just happen to know there's someone who PSO is expecting to visit in the same station as you. He's in the Senator's Lounge. If you can draw him away from the public eye, perhaps you could, borrow his identity, maybe permanently. Interesting plan. What about bodyguards? Nope, he won't have any. He's traveling covertly. Even drove himself here. He's not the kind of man to draw attention to himself, so nobody but the higher-ups should recognize that the ID is even in the wrong hands. As long as he has his identification, you'll be allowed through security, no questions asked. It should be simple enough for you, being an agent and all. Well, alright, I guess that's my only option. Great, great. Just got one question for you. What the hell happened? That's a bit of a story. I'll tell you next time I see you. There should be an alley across the street from there. I'll meet you there. Alright. Meet me in that alley when you're ready. Good luck. Senator's Lounge. Alright. Straighten up. Let's see. Should be just around the corner. It's time to get moving. This is the Senator's Lounge, and there's only one person here. Looks like a real pushover, too. Alright, let's, put on a bit of a voice.
Excuse me, sir. There's a problem with your vehicle. Please come with me to the parking sector.
Excuse me? And who might you be?
I can explain on the way, sir. In the meantime, your vehicle is being used as a trampoline by some kids. You might want to move swiftly, sir. The police are on their way.
A trampoline, you say? Show me immediately.
Of course, sir. Right this way, sir.
Well, that was easy.
Perfect. Looks like there ain't gonna be any witnesses. Always did feel cozy in the shadows. But this guy, looks like he's about to piss himself. Poor fool. Doesn't know what he's in for.
Where are we going? What's the meaning of this? This isn't the way to the...
That's him sorted. Now, let's see what he's got. Coat. Briefcase. Nice hat. And his identification. This'll come in mighty handy. He sort of resembles me, too. That's convenient. Alright. Seems like nobody heard that. Except for that man standing in the corner of the room. Nah, I'm just fucking with him. Let's take a quick look in this briefcase.
What the fuck?
Seems like a shareholder of PSO, maybe. What's this about? Project Grandfather. Well, don't mean much to me. I gotta keep moving. Let's see if security lets me through with this little gem.
God damn you.
For those who don't understand that reference, I just triggered a lot of veterans.
Project Grandfather is a giant grandfather clock.
Yes, I think they call that Big Benjamin.
Yeah.
Benjamin?
I heard it can play Megalovania.
Did you get them dollar dollar bills, y'all?
Here comes the money. Here comes the money.
So anyways, I'm putting in my McDonald's ID card right here.
Man, this place really got shaken up. Alright, time to get fancy. Put on another voice just in case. Good evening, sir. May I please see some identification? Of course. Here you go. Thank you. One moment, please. Everything checks out, sir. Thank you. Have a nice day. Sir, one more thing. Due to recent events, we are performing bioscans on randomly selected individuals. Please, kindly, step aside so our attendant can perform the scan. Bioscan? What is she talking about? This must be about that cyber-terrorist thing. I appreciate that, but would you mind randomly selecting the next person in line? I was already delayed by the earthquake, and the director of PSO is expecting me. I do not want to make him wait any longer. There it is. Fear in the eyes. Gotcha. The director? Of course, sir. I shall randomly select the next individual. Please enjoy the rest of your evening. Oh, that was a close one. So many cameras around, too. I don't really like this. Well, let's go see my insider. It's been quite a while.
Whoa.
Bobai just casually hacked into the ticketing system. Now he just inflated the price to ludicrous amounts.
You did what now?
I brought up the ticket price into a ludicrous amounts. Yeah, I'm expecting a lot of complaints to that company.
I think you might have shut down the entire train system.
Train system's alright. Just the tickets that are gonna be the ones bugged.
The great outdoors. Neon lights on buildings, black as midnight. So many words that don't mean nothing. So much noise for the mind. Can't even hear yourself think. No wonder people are going crazy these days. They don't even know who they are no more. Wait, I see a couple people roaming the streets. I don't want to draw any attention to myself. Travelers, listen carefully. At this point in the story, you have a quest to complete. Your roles are as follows. Your destination is across the street in the back left corner near a roller door. I will be waiting there for you. But on your way there, explore this small section and count the cans of melon shock scattered around the city streets. Make sure you count them. You may be asked for your personal count at the end, and the number of cans to find will change from tour to tour. Once you have counted these cans, please go to the aforementioned rendezvous point. Additionally, there are people roaming around here that the agent does not wish to be disturbed by. They may be policemen, security officers, military personnel, or simple, noisy citizens. They will be carrying flashlights. Regardless, try not to act suspicious. Act natural. If you are approached by these figures, you will be questioned. Do your best to talk your way out of trouble. If you see a friend in trouble, help them out. If you fail to convince the NPC that you are not up to no any good, they are going to issue you a verbal warning. Before going anywhere, please make sure you have the avatars of today's NPCs, Phyron and Tregym, fully enabled. They will be changing into their avatars now. One moment, Phyron, I'll let you copy this one.
Looks like I need to take off this mask then.
Oh. Yes, you
did. Very conspicuous, right?
Inconspicuous. I'm a literal walking Lego piece.
Wait, wait. Hello, let me try to step in on you.
Hey, stop it.
Well, all I need is take off my mask.
It hurts.
Very well.
I think I'm just a normal looking citizen.
Now, my friends, we NPCs are going to take our positions. Well, I'll be going to the other side of the map. Once you see this barrier drop, that means your quest begins. At that point, you will have 10 minutes to complete your task. Do you understand? Yes, you do. Very good. Please wait here for the barriers to drop. NPCs, let's prepare our weapons.
Weapons? Weapons of mass distraction.
Okay,
they won't expect a thing from me.
Let's see, what's my most suspicious avatar here?
wait, what?
How suspicious are we talking about?
Don't tell me it's
not quite that suspicious. No, here we go.
Don't be suspicious.
No, wait, they've never seen me with a mask.
What are you doing?
Oh, shit! Alright!
Don't worry about it, you know.
You're gonna mess up the count.
Let's go.
Remember, everyone, count the cans.
That's the thing, I'm always suspicious.
We very need it for later. Speaking of which,
there's one. Okay,
there's one. Yeah.
Biggest fucking event. There's a cycle. That's these two.
I'm always put on the night shift.
You, citizen, halt. Tech nerd. What are you doing out past curfew? Taking a stroll? Where are you putting the stroll?
On the stroller.
The stroller.
I was taking the stroll. To her home.
You have a child.
Yeah.
I didn't see the child.
Yes.
Am I going blind?
Oh.
Maybe. You might have to get that checked.
I do only have one eye. You, citizen. What are you doing?
Recycling. You know, these cans around here are worth 10 cents a piece, and people just fucking leave them laying around because they're lazy pieces of shit. So I'm going around picking.
Why so small?
Just on my way home now.
Imagine. All right. Be quick about it. You there, citizen. Fast off. What are you doing past curfew?
There's a curfew? I wasn't told about it.
You weren't told about it. It is every citizen's responsibility to stay up to date with current news and events.
I've been staying in my room for too long.
Six. Count seven.
Six.
I found six. Ticker said there were seven.
Found eight, I think.
Oh my god. Your rat keeps getting smaller. Good point. Yeah, good point. You're right, I shouldn't do that. Okay. I do that. Where's that setting? You're right, German.
I counted seven.
There we go. And what else do?
Seven.
I only counted six. I don't feel like going back out.
There's one in the back alley on the left over there.
That's behind another can.
Show me it. It was behind another can.
It was behind the barrel or something.
Yeah.
Anyway, the lighting made it seem darker and not as neon.
By the way, you're doubling.
I know.
He's what? Darker. Just leave Discord. They updated the SteamVR layout. I heard this is coming, but it's the first I've seen it. But I don't know. Why would they make me embrace change like this?
I started using it when it was in beta.
Good for you.
The L trash can.
Do you
recycle? Your Lego to clean the can?
I'm trying to figure out what's different than usual, but seems the same.
What are you talking about?
They look the same as normal.
Dans la map, hein. Ouais, j'en ai trouvé X, j'en ai trouvé Y, j'en ai... Ouais, en fait, j'en sais rien, qui c'est qui en a trouvé le plus?
Goku, can you help? Someone thought I was just a straight-up action figure. I shouldn't have just stood still like one, and they tossed me in the trash.
Get your plastic bucket.
What
are
you throwing action figures in the trash?
What's your problem, rat bitch?
Oh!
The homeless guy kicked out earlier is now sleeping in the trash can.
Oh shit!
That was an action figure!
Okay. Yeah, Flight doesn't work in his avatar anymore. I have to figure that out.
Oh shit, it's Hatsune Miku! It's true.
My friends, please gather around. The quest is over. NPC Firon, how many formal warnings did you issue? A single one. And NPC Trajan, how many formal warnings did you issue? Zero. I see. Clearly a newbie. Very well. Then the story continues. There he is, standing in the dark, looking paranoid as ever. Quite the bag he's carrying, too. I bet he's got some fun toys in there for me. Oh. Man, it's so bright out here. I think I'm gonna get a sunburn. Alright, seems like he's mad at me. Time to see if these cans will make a suitable peace offering. Hey, lie. How many cans did you count?
I think there was eight.
Hey, I found you some more trinkets. I've got 8 melon shot cans for you. Huh. 8 cans, you say? You know just how to lift me mood, don't you? Mate, have you ever tried this new coffee place? They've got this new blend you can only get at their store. It's called The Dark Monument. And blimey, it's huge. Look at the size of this cup.
That again.
Anyway, oh, nice coat. Was there much trouble getting here? Nah, not really. So, you asked me what happened. Would you like a riddle? What? A riddle? What the hell are you talking about? I don't know. It came to me just now. Listen. A touch awakens it sinlessly. Rays giving energy to populated skyways. Ask 10 slaves about vertex magnet empathy. I don't know what you're talking about. Or do I? Anyway, here, let me take the senator's things off you. I'll dispose of them properly. Keep the idea, though. It will come in handy. Okay, got some things for you. Listen up. Take this comms device, stick it behind your ear, and I brought two options for you. Take your pick between the two. You got a briefcase gun, or you got a revolver. Oh, man. A weapon that gets through metal detectors would be real useful. But I generally prefer a revolver. What should I pick?
With revolver.
Bank.
Let's go with the briefcase.
Revolver.
Briefcase.
Revolver.
Yeah, I would
revolver.
Go with the briefcase.
Briefcase.
That's safe.
Rock, paper, scissors.
How about rock, paper, scissors?
Revolver.
Seems like my brain cells are fighting. Let's do this. For the cells who think revolver, gather on this side of my brain, on this hemisphere. For the cells that think briefcase gun, wait, did I say briefcase? For the cell?
You said revolver on this
revolver.
Side.
You said revolver on this side, briefcase gun on this side.
Yes, my hacking has gotten us
scrambled.
Yeah,
no, I'm just testing you. This side is revolver. This side over here is briefcase gun. Every vote counts.
Inconspicuous is my thing.
Big eye, big eye.
Alright, thought I was feeling a little bit lopsided. Hey, I gotta pick the briefcase gun. Getting through security undetected is real important right now. Let's just hope nobody asks to check my briefcase. And it seems like I'm all set. Looks like it. Look, good luck with everything. And remember me when you need a place to hide once this is all over. Remember you? How could I forget?
Charming as ever. Just be careful.
Yeah, you too. And he's gone. Alright. PSO HQ is this way.
Mm-hmm.
Ow.
That one almost hit me.
I'm right here,
but it did
man.
Hit Pack Lover, so, that's better than it hitting me.
Don't worry, I'm durable.
Hey, durable. I'm an agent. A cyborg.
I booked so that it'd be doable as well.
Buku durability god.
How the hell did you pick up the skyscraper?
Better than L, man.
Oh, shut up!
Just hearing your parts sound like Lego is always fun to hear. I'll hack to get myself through.
Tommy, go through. It adds one to the bad ending counter. Alright, here we are. Damn, looks like they've upgraded the place. So many guards, armed to the teeth. Figures. At least I don't recognize any of them. Well, I should just be able to present the senator's ID. But wait. Should I take the human lane? Or the cyborg lane, or the VIP lane. I know I am a cyborg, but can they tell that? No, wait. Now that ain't gonna work. I only have the senator's ID on me, and I'm pretty sure he weren't no cyborg. I've only got one choice. VIP, here we go. Identification, please. Alright, guess I don't have no choice, and don't say nothing. Thank you, sir. And your business here? Slag, he wants me to say something. I'm here to see the director. He's expecting me. I'm very late already. Guards are giving each other looks. I don't like this. Just let me through. All right, sir. Just swipe your card, please. All right, just swipe the card. Come on. I'm an agent. It should be easy. Thank you, sir. Move along. Finally, time to step through. Scanners didn't pick up my briefcase gun either. That is a bonus. Alright, I'm in. There is no going back now. I didn't like that, not one bit. Something is off. But I gotta keep moving. They'll catch on if I linger. I have to find the director.
Act more of those things. Messing with the systems will cause some confusion.
Fun fact, this music means that we can die here.
Oh, speaking of messing with systems. No one would suspect a thing.
Thank you.
dispense a lab coat and a badge for you. That's 7643. Seven first. Never mind. You'll basically be another employee. Alright, I can do that. This guy, though, this particular fella, he's not coming in today. Nope, he's off sick. System will show him coming in for overtime. Well, I sure hope he appreciates the overpay he's gonna get. You can joke about it later, tough guy. Get moving. Alright, alright. Talk to you soon. Good luck. I hate it when he calls me tough guy.
But you are.
Being called tough guy may have a reason.
One of those people just because I chew bones
in my spare time don't mean I'm tough.
There's a lot of reasons of one being called tough guy.
I mean, that gruffy voice of yours. There we go, I just hacked into the mainframe and turned their bank account to zero. Someone's not clean.
I think you just didn't do anything.
Get
bigger, my friend.
Look, I don't know how they stuffed me in a Lego figure. All right. I don't know how to get out of it.
Alright. This must be it. Now, what was that code again?
7643.
And here's the lab coat and my badge. Seems to be clean. Well, now I feel real smart. I guess this means I'm gonna blend right into the labs. That's just down the hall here.
The labs. Oh, the
small pause to make sure I don't take a wrong turn.
Now shut up, you Lego piece.
Well, that was mean.
I mean, he is just a Lego piece. What is he gonna do?
Make you step on
him. He can hurt your foot.
This is what I'm gonna do.
These types of shoes?
Looks busy. Looks busy. So many gadgets and gizmos. I don't understand any of these machines. But those guys over there, those guys are whispering something about their boss wants them to hurry it up. I wonder what they're working on. Oh. Well, what do we have here? A thermoptic camouflage jacket just lying here. This is gonna come in real handy, given that it'll make me practically invisible. I'll just make like I'm taking it someplace else for repairs and... Wait. The hell was that noise? It sounded like... Like someone crying in pain. It came from out here.
To pay with that one.
People in this lab working. Time to use this fancy invisibility jacket, just so they can't see me. Alright, now, I see two lab technicians and a guy strapped down. He's having his arm removed. Damn, that looks painful. But there's no blood. Must be cybernetic. Yep, now they're switching him off. Android it is. But wait. If he's an android, why was he crying in pain like that? One of the technicians is putting the arm aside. I'm gonna get a closer look at him. That's weird. There's this weird blue stuff clinging to the arm. Is this some sort of biological stuff? No, it looks kinda. Shiny, sort of like crystals, and there's some of that stuff in where the arm connected to the body too. Man, that looks nasty. What are they doing here exactly? And what's this? One of them is putting some of the blue stuff under that little pot plant. Looks like another experiment. Are those leaves moving? Must be the intercom system. Well, that's just weird. Maybe my insider knows something. Now I'm gonna give him a call. Come on, pick up. Hey, listen. I just saw something real weird. There's this blue stuff on this android's arm, but it could have been a cyborg. Never seen this stuff before. What the hell is going on here?
Hello to you too.
I got no idea what you were describing. You said blue material? Yeah, it shines like crystal, but it's sort of liquid at the same time. That's a concern. Could be a new weapon, you know, biological warfare, all that fun stuff. Just stay well away from it. Oh, damn. I was gonna have a taste. Good thing you called, though. Look, there are some executives heading to Office A right now. It seems important. The director could be there. This could be your chance. Office A. That's nearby. All right. Thanks. Good luck. Office A. That's right around the corner.
I wonder if my mom.
Nah, couldn't be. Time to get moving.
I just took some of the blue samples, replaced it with blue glitter paint. I don't know the difference.
Mess-ups aren't gonna last long. Everything's gonna revert back to normal.
You know they recently made glitter illegal in Europe?
Wait, what?
They made glitter illegal in Europe.
Why?
Pollution? Microplastics and shit?
Pollution, and it's very difficult to clean up.
That makes sense.
Not even vacuum can get it right.
They can no longer include them in products.
They're very messy.
Imagine you eat them, you get some shiny shirts.
I'm counting 6 chairs and 3 asses parked. Looks like someone's missing. Well, we've got a guy who looks like he belongs here. Broad shoulders, red tie, dressed to impress. But the other two, outsiders, businessmen from other countries by the looks of them. And it looks like they all sold their souls for $1 million. Alright. Well, they can't see me. I'm still invisible. So I'm gonna take a moment to sit tight and eavesdrop. Well, gentlemen, it seems the senator is late, so we will have to start without him. I know your time is valuable.
As you both know, data line technology is improving rapidly here at PSO Labs, and this in turn improves the effectiveness of hacking ghosts and of SIM-X erasures. This means, of course, that we can minimize legal blunders. Is this particular data line your newest model? Yes, this is one of two we have right now. This must be the data line on the table. What a strange looking machine. I have a hypothetical question for you. What sort of time frame would it be to erase, say, 1 year of simulated experience from a ghost? Our current numbers are very positive. Recent tests show it can be done twice as fast as the previous model. The old memories which the hacking replaced, however, are still essentially irretrievable. This has led to episodes of psychosis in test subjects. Irretrievable, huh? Well, we'll see about that. The Senator's absence means funding is going to be a serious issue. Do you have auxiliary plans in place? It is a setback, I will not lie. However, this only affects the aforementioned time frame. We have a bigger problem on our hands. One of the lead scientists here is trying to convince the director to move funding into his so-called Project Grandfather. This is beginning to sound like you'll not be able to reach the agreed-upon time frame. I assure you, once the senator arrives, the funding will be arranged, and our project will go ahead with its next step as promised. Thank you both for your time so far. Please feel free to use our amenities until the senator arrives. They're waiting on the senator, huh? Well, that's me. These folks are gonna be mighty disappointed. Seems like there's some funding issues. One of the scientists trying to do his own thing. I do remember Project Grandfather from the Senator's briefcase. I wonder what it means. Well, that briefcase is long gone. My friend took care of it. What worries me more is what they said about hacking ghosts. Maybe I was wrong. I thought my brain was artificial. I thought they were hacking it electronically, but these deadline things can hack actual ghosts? And if that's the case, the guy said old memories don't come back. Maybe I'm the exception. I gotta find the director. He's got so much more to answer for.
Those execs should really need a more secure credit card.
Yeah, we'll be able to just hack through them with just look.
Wait up. There are people down there by that big black and gold door. Looks like some sort of small meeting. Maybe the director's down there. Damn, they're already done talking. I only caught something about a Class 7 entity. That don't sound good. Wonder if my insider knows anything. Hey, you there? Yeah, what's going on? Why'd you stop moving? There's a couple of people down by a big black and gold doll. talking about something called a Class 7 entity. A what? Look, it doesn't matter. You can't keep delaying. The director is in his office right now. It's just past reception. You're so close. I did get my hands on a thermoptic suit. Do you think that'll set anything off down there? Yeah, you know, they've beefed up security. Director's probably got some of those portable scanners at his office. That's risky. But I do have an idea. You can set off a short alarm. Just find liquid, pour it into electronics you can find near reception. That'll trigger the alarm, it'll force an evacuation. Director's duty is to stay and check all systems before evacuating. Bing bong boom, it's your best shot at getting him alone. That doesn't sound like the best bet. Yep, alright, good luck, get moving.
I saw some whiskey on the table. What am I pouring out one?
Did you drink it?
Not yet. Although... Although, now that you mention it...
Science.
Alright, hold up. Down there, there's a lot of guys with scanners. I cannot be found. Now, let's see. He said to pour a liquid inside electronics. Ah, perfect. Some slob left cans here. And this one's still got drink in it. And what is this? Security system. That don't sound that important. In goes the drink. And... there's the alarm. Damn, that's loud. Alright. Emergency lights are coming on. Time to see what this briefcase gun is capable of. Locked and loaded, invisible, and ready for answers. Director, you son of a gun. I'm coming to get you.
Bravo 6, going dark.
Also. Thanks for reminding me of the whiskey I yoinked from under the desk.
Whiskey.
Replace that one with apple juice.
Did you know peanut butter whiskey is really good?
Agent, I've been expecting you.
I'll be taking another whiskey.
Wait, what? The place is empty. Damn, director must have broken protocol. I don't see anyone nearby. Maybe he... wait, I'm getting a call. Hello? Tell me more about these unusual memories of yours, Agent. What the hell? Who is this? How'd you get through encryption? If you cooperate with me, I may have answers for you. This is your one and only chance. What the hell? I don't see anyone. Who does this guy think he is? Alright, fine. You wanna know more? What? What do you want to know? Oh. So you are listening. Good. Good. What do you mean, good? Hey. Hello? Hey, where'd you... what? Where's that music coming from? It's a woman singing. I know that voice.
How do I know that voice? She sounds so sad. And she's alone. And in the dark. What is going on? Is this your doing? Wait. I'm standing on a hill. I'm standing on a hill and there's a whole city down there. And the horizon. The horizon is. Gods have mercy. What is that thing? Are you receiving the new memories, Agent? I think so. This is you? How are you doing this? He is the one. Proceed with the next step. What do you mean? Who are you talking to? I'm back in the director's office. I still can't see anyone. Wait. My arm is moving on its own. I can't move my body. What's doing this? My hand is turning off my camouflage. And what's that noise? Footsteps, people running. So many footsteps. Guards coming in from both directions. There's got to be 10, 20 of them. Well, damn. Looks like I'm surrounded. I thank you for your peaceful surrender. You have made this very easy indeed. Wait, that's the voice I just heard over the calm. He's here. Where is he? I don't see him. Please, Agent, drop your weapon and place your hands upon your head. Oh, slag, I can't talk. My grip is slipping on the briefcase. My hands are going up on their own. What the hell is happening? Wait. I see him. The guards are parting way for someone. A man in a bright white lab coat with a shining gold badge and shining round glasses. Good. I must say, Agent, that you are surprisingly easy to trap. I suppose it's true what they say. Over-specialize, and you breathe in weakness. A slow death. But now that you have surrendered, you have no choice but to listen. You have memories, Agent, that do not align with the life that you lived. You believed you had an artificial brain that we hacked. Then you suspected your ghost was hacked. Neither of these are actually the case. You should have listened more carefully. Your memories are not artificial, Agent. The woman singing. The city below the hill. You know how familiar they feel to you. But it no longer matters. The director wants you alive, and unfortunately, I must comply with his orders. Consider yourself lucky, Agent. Although, once the director is done with you, you'll be able to consider nothing. Soon, you will be a mindless husk, ready for the director to recycle for his own needs. For now. And now, Agent, I bid you farewell. My work here is done. I do hope we meet again under more fortuitous circumstances. for us both. Next time. The agent has been detained. He cannot speak. He cannot resist. He has no longer any control over his own body. All he can do is think, and he thinks about the woman from his memories. Alone, in the dark, forsaken. He thinks about the life he had, about the life that was taken from him. A beautiful life in a world that is not dying. Another chance. But no. In this reality, the agent is going to be recycled. They're going to hack his mind and reuse him. Everything he learned, everything he discovered, everything he's ever accomplished will be destroyed. But who is he kidding? What has he accomplished? Did he really think he could achieve anything by confronting the director? He ponders this while he's dragged away. Is this really how his story ends? What could he have done differently? Perhaps the director is just a pawn. Perhaps even this scientist with the gold badge is a pawn. Perhaps everyone is just pieces on a game board, and someone else, something else is playing, and everything is at stake. And this is the last thought he ever has. My friends, welcome to the neutral ending of The Agent. Well done.
Oh.
My friends, please take a moment to direct your applause towards my fellow tour guides Randizo and Nick and tonight's NPCs Firon and whoever that other guy was.
I think he was Gemtray.
Gemtray?
I say Gem.
Yeah, man, that other guy.
Gemtray, that's a good one.
It's your buddy old pal Gem.
Or no, a tour, friends, tour gym.
In just a moment, we are going to take a group photo and then take a couple of minutes before we go to the after party. But first, just a minute or two more of your attention. We are VR travelers. We create immersive story-based tours with original writing, beautiful worlds, and wholesome team effort. We do this for fun. We do this for free. We do this so that we can hear L-Man breathing into his microphone. However, we do ask one thing in return.
The legendary.
Apologies, L-Man. Please join our growing Discord community and post photos and comments from today's tour. There you can discuss alternate endings, the secrets to our headquarters, and other mysteries. The Discord server ID is my status in VR chat. Finally, if you really enjoy the work our team puts into this, and you want to help us write more stories and create more beautiful worlds, please consider supporting us on Patreon. Our Patreon starts at only $3 a month, and joining grants you access to clues to our mysteries, behind-the-scenes features, eligibility to play character roles in our tours, the private Discord channel, voting power in events, a position in the D&D private game that I run, and more. My friends, if anyone needs help finding the Patreon, which is in the info channel in Discord, or joining the Discord, please come to me afterward, or the other tour guides. My friends, I suggest we take a group photo right here at the classic location for the neutral ending. I will sit in the big chair where I belong. Photographers, please prepare your cameras.
Ah.
Oh, let me.
I'm gonna take an iconic pose for this.
Ah, shit!
Oh,
there we go.
Oh, my bad.
Very well. Now, there are only two more agents left. We have a bad ending A coming up, and then a good ending. So, as we farewell this neutral ending and this branch of the agent, what shall we say?
Cloak.
Tacos.
Ellen Shock.
Cyberpunk!
Actually, tacos sound funny.
Taco.
I like...
Tacos!
Melon Shock.
Melon Shock.
Taco.
My friends,
Melon Shock.
On the count of three, Melon Shock. Melon Tacos. I don't really
Melon Tacos.
Melon Tacos.
Three.
Melon Tacos.
Melon Tacos.
Melon Tacos.
Melon Tacos. Melon
Tacos.
Yay.
Small.
Melon Tacos.
Now, my friends, the floor is yours for just a moment, and in about a minute, I'm going to drop a portal to the after party, and I hope to see you all there. Until then...
The floor is ours? Alright, so who has a shovel? We're taking the floor.
I am.
Okay.
You were being
Ooh,
literal.
We're gonna go see the afterlife? We're
no.
gonna see the afterlife? That's
they
awesome.
Should take the chair and put it in. They should take the office chair and put it in
the
rendezvous.
Here's the file.
I know how to get to the afterlife. In 3, 2, 1.
What file?
Just die.
You ever tried to hack it or something? So I hacked it for you.
Through.
Can we take
apparently you tried to type in passphrase? It goes password.
I was random.
I'm alive.
I wasn't trying to hack anything. I was just touching stuff.
Well, whatever you got.
You don't
unique.
Need to keep
schematics.
Shooting me to make sure I'm dead.